The caffeine. What are the effects of caffeine in coffee or tea? Caffeine is a central nervous system stimulant that may reduce drowsiness and fatigue. Caffeine mildly stimulates the nervous and cardiovascular systems. The best known source of caffeine is coffee bean, tea leaves, and kola nuts. Caffeine is extracted by steeping the grounded coffee beans, tea leaves in water. This process is called infusion. Therefore, people ingest caffeine when drinking coffee and tea. Chocolate also contains caffeine because chocolate is prepared with cocoa beans, which contain caffeine. Foods and beverages containing chocolate contain caffeine as well. When consumed in moderate amounts, caffeine can have a positive health effect. A moderate amount of caffeine refers to less than 4 cups of 8 fluid ounce cups of coffee. On the other hand, caffeine has adverse health effects when consumed in overdoses. First, let us talk about the effects of caffeine on the central nervous system. Caffeine is best known for its central nervous system stimulant. Caffeine decreases fatigue and increases attentiveness. Once an 8 ounces cup of coffee is consumed, caffeine increases heart rate, blood flow, respiratory rate, and metabolic rate for several hours. At regular doses, caffeine generally improves wakefulness and cognitive performance. Because caffeine is both water and fat soluble, after consumption within 1 hour or so, caffeine readily crosses the blood-brain barrier and gives people an elevated mood, awakeness, along improved concentration. Exactly how caffeine affects people and how long depends on many factors such as the amount of caffeine ingested, gender, height and weight, age and health conditions. Next, let's talk about the positive effects of caffeine in the prevention of some chronic diseases. The moderate use of caffeine may offer health benefits. Both coffee and tea contain health-promoting phytochemicals. The reasonable use of caffeine is less than 400 milligrams, equal to about 4 cups of coffee daily. Extensive research works have been conducted on how caffeine affects health. Most research results show that moderate caffeine use up to 400 milligrams is not likely to cause health problems. 400 milligrams of caffeine are the total caffeine consumption of 4 cups of 8 fluid ounce regular drip brewed coffee. In addition, some research results show that regular caffeine consumption reduces the risk of type 2 diabetes and the risk of developing Parkinson's disease. It also may protect people from liver cirrhosis. A protective effect of caffeine against dementia and Alzheimer's disease is possible. However, the evidence is inconclusive. All these positive effects of caffeine lie in caffeine being an antioxidant that captures the harmful free radicals generated in the human body. Therefore, caffeine may stop or slow down the destructive oxidation process in the human body. Furthermore, let us talk about the caffeine amount usually contained in our coffee, tea, and chocolate. The caffeine content of coffee depends on the variety of the coffee bean or tea leaf, the particle size, the brewing method, the amount of water used, and the length of brewing or steeping time. Let's have a rough idea about the caffeine content in coffee. How much caffeine is contained in a cup of regular brewed coffee? Here the cup size is 8 fluid ounces, which is equal to 240 milliliters. So the answer is about 100 milligrams of caffeine are contained in the 8 fluid ounce cup, as mentioned above of coffee. Espresso has more caffeine than an equal volume of brewed coffee. Espresso is made by forcing hot pressurized water through finely ground coffee beans. Because espresso is brewed with less and higher pressure water, it contains more caffeine than regular coffee per fluid ounce. For example, a 2 fluid ounce of espresso may contain 150 milligrams of caffeine. An 8 fluid ounce of brewed green tea from a tea bag has about 44 milligrams of caffeine. Chocolate also has caffeine. For example, 40 grams commercially sold dark chocolate bar may have 20 milligrams of caffeine, and 48 grams of MAM chocolate candies have about 7 milligrams of caffeine. Numerous medication drugs also contain caffeine. It is often used in headache and pain relief remedies and cold products. Next, let us discuss the metabolism rate of caffeine in our bodies. The metabolism of caffeine in the human body is characterized by a parameter named biological half-life. Half-life is the time required for the body to eliminate one half of a dose of caffeine intake in a beverage usually. The half-life of caffeine in healthy adults is between 3 and 7 hours. The half-life of caffeine varies widely among individuals according to the factors such as other drugs, liver enzyme function level, etc. Last, let us talk about the side effects of caffeine. One side effect is that caffeine is mildly addicting. Even when moderate amounts of caffeine are withdrawn for 18 to 24 hours, people may feel symptoms such as fatigue, headache, and lowered concentration. However, the symptoms are generally mild and temporary. To minimize withdrawal symptoms, experts recommend reducing caffeine intake gradually. A high level of caffeine represents a health risk. At high doses of 600 mg, about 6 cups of coffee, or more daily, caffeine can cause nervousness, sweating, tenseness, and upset stomach, anxiety, and insomnia. In summary, the moderate intake of caffeine through coffee or tea or foods containing caffeine has some beneficial health values. The average caffeine intake counts for less than 4 cups of 8 fluid ounces of regular grounded drip brewed coffee. Sutasty made this video. Thank you for your watching, and see you next time.